Hello and welcome once again to Beer Goggles. 1 minute, let's just move that around a bit. Oh, that's it. Hello and welcome once again to Beer Goggles Reviews. Whiskey Watch, because I'm doing a whiskey again. As is my wont, I do enjoy a whiskey. I'm not kind of in the realms of you guys like your Ralphie stuff and people like that. I do enjoy them, and I kind of just impart what I taste and try to give you a little bit of what I'm picking up on the way. But share stuff with me, by all means. I've got one here, in a triple box. It's one the missus got for me. A famous grass. I think that's one of them words that get pronounced different everywhere. I've no doubt people call it goose, grass. I don't know. It's like gross probably or something like that in Canada, because they call stout stout or stout stout. It's a lovely stuff, isn't it? Well, I'm doing the kind of middle one here, the old run of the mill one. Now, I'll tell you what I do with these. Now, I don't know what sort of colouring they've got in that. But I imagine, and I don't know for sure, but I kind of imagine that it is, it's a blended one, and I imagine it's kind of E150s in there. Because otherwise it's very, very light coloured, and it picks up its colour from, or a proper, you know, colouring whiskey picks it up from the barrels and everything. Now, I'll give you a little kind of just an hint how much colour you can get from different woods and what have you. Now, obviously, oak and the oak barrels, there's a lot less colour to be seeped out of them than in other stuff. Now, this is something I do for my coffee. You might want to try it. I get a kind of bottle of grass. Look at the colour difference here. Have a look at the colour difference. I put cinnamon sticks and that in there. Don't know if you can see all that there. Quite a lot of cinnamon sticks. And just give it a little shook up like that. And that gets really cinnamony. Cinnamon is actually good for a lot of things. It's kind of good for diabetes. Even though I'm getting a little bit of alcohol in there with it, you know. But and coffee's not good for diabetes now. But that's my little morning thing, you know. I have my cup of coffee, a little splosh of that in there. Lovely, I'm sorted for the day, you know. Make what you will of it, but that's what I'm doing, and it's all going good. Anyway, on with this. We've got the little tiny bottle there, the famous goose, the famous grouse, Mickey Mouse, famous grouse. And it's blended. I'm going to read off the bigger one here. Blended Scotch whisky. A marriage of the finest Scotch whiskies matured in seasoned oak barrels. Lovely. It's apparently as well, it's now in new lighter bottles. So it's reducing our carbon footprint. Whee! Means if you drop your shopping, you've just lost your bottle. Right, I've already had a little opened it, so I'm going to have a little, just a little sipper. Now, this is kind of one of the, I don't know if you can call them macro distilleries, but you know, you've got macro breweries and everything else. And this is one of your big, I think I poured a lot in. I think I'm going to do that from now on, because, there we go. Do you think I made sure I got the lot there? Even that last little bit. I'll keep the bottle, and Missy puts it on the finger like that and daps it on Littlen's teeth and that when she's teething. It's like, all of a sudden, ooh. I don't think I'm going to be putting water in this. I might do. I might put a tiniest little tad in there. Not even a teaspoon. Just to kind of open it a little bit. Kind of throw off a little bit of the harsh alcohol as well. Just settles it in, to smooths it, enriches it. Now you notice the difference. As soon as you put a tiniest little bit, some of the blends and that, they don't need it, but try them anyway. That one's needed it, that one. And now I'm picking out different notes in there. It's not just, it's not kind of just a kind of a cheapish sort of whiskey now. I'm getting little oaky notes. A little tad of vanilla and something like a berry of some sort, like a red grape or something like that. But it's not got the complexities of some of the single malts that you get, you know. There's a lot of complexities that ain't there. But there's some big kind of lush notes as well, which isn't too bad. But there's just none of those little roads and routes and meandering little courses that your tongue and your nose and everything takes with different kind of types of with whiskies and that, you know. Something like that Madeira cask Welsh one that I had, the Penderyn. Wow, that was something else. And it's just so many different complex flavours in that. But it's nice enough. It's kind of got a certain smoothness to it. And I'm diving in. I'm fed up talking about it because there's not that many flavour notes to be had. Cheers. Sláinte. Right. You're getting a... Let's get the four forerunners first before I get these background notes. You're getting kind of a bit of toffee, a bit of chocolate, like cocoa. You're getting a little bit of almost a bit of coffee as well. And like little currants and that in there. Then, right in the distant background, you're getting a tiny little hint of chalk, a little bit of chalky sort of. You know when you get one of these mineral waters that from a chalky area, you're getting that chalky sort of note in there as well, which is not altogether unpleasant. It's quite nice, but it adds a certain harshness to it, a kind of a hardness to the water almost. But that's it's still not bad. It's pretty good. Cheers. It is Billy Basic though. It's nice, and I couldn't imagine drinking it. I do drink it, but nowadays, like I say, I have it with a load of stuff and leave it in there for a while, let it steep. That one's what's that at about a week or something like that, and let it steep, and then I pour little dashes in my coffee, and it's lovely, you know. I do. Firmly suggest you try that. You know, there's a lot of whiskey drinks that be going, what? But you know, there you go. It's it's lovely, and also nice in porridge with a bit of cinnamon in it. Get your porridge, a little bit of that. Instead of having sugar and all that in your porridge, just a bit of that. Mix it all in, lovely. Nice flavours. Yeah, there's not a lot I can say about that. It's not bad, it's quite nice. Try it, buy it, like it. Yeah, I'd say try it, buy it, like it. Give it a go. The old famous grass. Cheers, bombs up.